Hello, and welcome to 5-Minute Math. Today we're looking at the fourth grade concept of fractions, specifically how we can determine whether two fractions are equivalent or not, and we'll do it in 5 minutes or less. So we're going to start with two simple fractions, 2/4 and 4/8. An equivalent means equal, so we're going to put a question mark there, and you see in the word equivalent you've got EQU and then an AL, so it's kind of easy to remember. Well, first, let's start by drawing pictures. Let's just take a basic circle, and let's just do your regular 2/4. So there's your 2/4. Now, the question is, can you make 4/8 out of the same amount of shading? And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with my 2/4. I'm going to draw the exact same picture as I did to the left. So I've got 2/4 on both. But now I'm going to see, can I cut these fourths into eighths? And you actually can. If you take an eight and 2/8, you make a fourth. Or the other way to think about it is if you take a fourth, cut it in half, you've got eighths. So you notice I didn't change any of the shading. I just made the pieces smaller. And so I've got the exact same amount. I've got 2/4 on the left, and I've got 4/8 on the right. Another way that you can look at it would be to look at the relationship between the numerators and the denominators. So if you wanted to multiply 2 times 2, you would get 4. You can multiply straight across. And if you multiplied 4 times 2, you would get 8. So since you can multiply the top and the bottom, the numerator and the denominator, by the same number, in this case, we can divide both, multiply both by 2, then this also shows that it is equivalent. The reason is because 2 halves, let me draw this right here. Remember, 2 halves is really just 1. Anytime you multiply anything by 1, it doesn't change, right? 3 times 1 is 3. 18 times 1 is 18. Well, guess what? I just made my 1 look like 2 halves. So that means I didn't really change it. I just made my 2/4 look different, but it's the same amount, which is what we've already proven by our drawing. 2/4 is equal to 4/8. Now, here's another way. So far we've looked at the pictures. We've looked at, can you multiply the numerator and denominator by the same number to get the second one? Sometimes you can do something that's called cross multiplication. So cross multiplication looks at the relationship between the product of one numerator and denominator and the other numerator and denominator. See how it makes a big X? So we're going to multiply this 2. So we're going to go 2, and we're going to multiply down like this. 2 times 8 equals 16. We're going to multiply it by this. 4 times 4 equals 16. And there we go. If you get the same product, that means those two are equivalent. One final thought would be to simplify both of these fractions. 2/4, if you divide, just like we did up here on the right, if you divide by 2 over 2, because 2 over 2 is 1, you're going to get 1/2. 4/8, I'm going to simplify, but I'm going to do a bigger number. I'm going to do 4 over 4, which is still equal to 1. Guess what you get? 1/2. So those are many different ways that you can use to determine whether two fractions are equivalent. Now it's time for you to try. Take a moment and try to determine whether 6/8 is equal to 9/12 using any of the methods that we've already discussed. When you've go ahead and pause the video, work it out, and when you finish with that, unpause the video and check your work. So first I drew 6/8 and 9/12. I think they're the same, but drawing 12 is kind of tough. So let me use another method. Let me do cross multiplication. So 6 times 12 is 72, and 8 times 9 is also 72. So that is a check. Those are equivalent. Let me see if I can simplify or reduce both of those. So we're going to simplify this by, let's do just by 2 over 2. Remember, when you simplify, the numerator and denominator need to be the same. So that's 3/4. So let's look at 9/12. And we're going to do this, by 3s, I think. And guess what? That's going to be 3/4 as well.